A home viewer gets to play What's in the Box. We're going to be making the call very soon. But first, she is one of the most successful female singers in Australia. A now four-time ARIA Award winner, Katie Noonan, has a new surprise for us. She is back with a brand new album, and this time she's brought along some friends and here to tell us all about it. Let's welcome her into Studio 10. It's Katie Noonan, everyone. You have the most remarkable, powerful voice. Your new album's called Songs That Made Me. You've listed songs like Mr. Sandman, Last Goodbye, The Chain. Mm-hmm. So these are the songs that developed you, do you think, as an artist?
Yeah, Songs That Made Me started as a concert tour last year. And then, so it's celebrating women and celebrating the sisterhood. And then I decided earlier this year to turn it into an album project. After I did the I Touch Myself campaign, which was Chrissy Amphlett's, the late, great Chrissy Amphlett's campaign for breast cancer awareness, I thought it'd be great to make an album that, with all the money going towards the Pink Ribbon campaign for the Cancer Council. We're dressed in the right colours.
We are, I know. And because your voice, it is like the voice of an angel, I think. I could listen to it again and again and again. And you have lots of different, I suppose, styles. I mean, pop, opera, jazz, just to name a few. Is there a particular style of singing that you like more than another or that you feel is really you?
No, for me, music's a genreless thing. Mm-hmm. Like, it doesn't really... Yeah, I just... As long as there's pure communication and you're singing from your heart and you're making a connection with people, the actual style doesn't really matter to me. I love the challenge of singing classical and opera, but then I love jazz and pop's my number one.
Like. We need to hear a little bit of you in action. Have a look at this. This is just incredible. They will keep on speaking her name. Some things change. Some stay the same, and she will always carry on. Something is lost, something is found. They will keep on speaking her name. Some things change, some stay the same. God, girl, this part's done.
Your latest album was a huge set of collaborations. Tell us something about that.
Well, I wanted it to include women from all stages of their career. So we have legends like Renee Geyer, Deborah Conway, Angie Hart, women who I look up to and who paved the way for me as an artist. Then peer, you know, contemporaries of myself like Kylie Aldist and Ainsley Wills, and then more up-and-coming artists like Sahara Beck and Melody Poole. And so it's a real... And Stonefield, who are the four girls.
Yeah, they're rockers. Right? Yeah, they're fantastic.
They do a rocking version of The Chain by Fleetwood Mac.
I love that song.
Yeah, so it's a real snapshot of artists at various stages of their development, I guess. Yeah.
As someone with so much talent, what do you think? There was an opinion piece in one of the papers over the weekend that basically claimed that the pop stars of today have become porn stars. Obviously you do not fall into that category, but what do you make of these sort of new, kind of this new generation of pop star coming through and trying to shock with sex and that type of thing?
I think if you have to resort to that, there's something missing from your music. It's as simple as that. All the great artists, it doesn't matter what you look like. Half the time when I listen to music, my eyes are shut. So, you know, it doesn't matter what you look like. It's the art that you create. And if you have to take clothes off to sell music, there's something lacking in your music.
Congratulations. This is awesome. 100% of the money is going towards a very, very good cause. Yeah. Great influencers, great artists. You'll be, you know, to be congratulated, Roy.
Yeah, Katie Noonan, everyone. Yeah. And Katie Albom's Songs That Made Me is out now. If you want to see her on tour, make sure you head down to katienoonan.com. Good Brisbane girl, am I right?
Yes.
Yay!